It was in 2020 when Emmanuel Charpentier and Jennifer Doudna was announced as the winner of the Nobel Prize in Chemistry for their work in CRISPR-Cas9 gene editing. When the news broke out, there were lots of excitement about the potential and prospects of working with CRISPR. So what exactly is CRISPR and where did it come from? CRISPR is short for Clustered Regularly Interspaced Short Palindromic Repeats. It was originally found in the immune systems of bacteria and archaea, and it works by storing short fragments of foreign sequences, protospaces, into its own genome to protect itself against invading viral and plasmids. The DNA of prokaryotes will then be transcribed into RNA and it will be broken down into short pieces of CRISPR RNA, crRNAs, that can be base paired with complementary sequence of invading viral and plasmids. A transactivating CRISPR RNA, tracer RNA, is a small non-coding RNA that will bind to crRNA to trigger processing of pre-crRNA and activating crRNA guided cleavage. The crRNA and tracer RNA can then be fused into a chimeric single guide RNA, sgRNA. The guide RNA will eventually bind to an endonucleus called CRISPR-associated protein 9, Cas9, to form the CRISPR-Cas9 complex. Each crRNA contains 20 nucleotide sequence and will guide the Cas9 to the target DNA. The target DNA must lie at the protospacer adjacent motif, PEM, 3' end of the guide RNA to cleave targeted DNA. This will destroy the invading viral and plasmids and protect the bacteria and archaea. But wait a second. Behind this cool genome editing technology, who actually discovered CRISPR and when did it happen? To answer all this, we go back all the way to 1993 when Francisco Mojica first described the CRISPR locus in halophilic archaeon halopharynx mediterranean, a kind of archaea found in hypersaline environments like the Dead Sea. In 2002, Francisco Mojica coined the term short, regularly spaced repeats SRSRS when he found a peculiar type of repeated sequences in prokaryotes, and the repeated sequences are also palindromic in nature. SRSRS later went on to be named as CRISPR. In 2004, Francisco Mojica decides to investigate the origin of CRISPR in his paper, Intervening Sequences of Regularly Spaced Prokaryotic Repeats Derived from Foreign Genetic Elements. He analyzed 4,500 CRISPR spaces from 67 strains consisting of 36 genera of prokaryotes to investigate the origins of such intervening sequences and the relationship it had with foreign DNA such as bacteriophages and conjugative plasmids. In the experiment, PCR reaction was carried out for every strain and subsequently, a computer software was used to analyze its genome sequence. Mojica found that about 2/3 of the spacer homologs have direct relations with either bacteriophages or conjugative plasmids, as there were numerous similarities in sequences that were found in both prokaryotes and the bacteriophages, while the remaining 1/3 of the spacer homologs were not directly related to foreign genetic elements. In addition, it was also found that strains of prokaryotes with spacer sequences similar to invading viruses have specific immunity against it. For example, Staphylobus sulfatericus S. sulfatericus that has CRISPR spacers similar to Staphylobus islandicus rod-shaped virus 1, SIRV virus, displays specific immunity when it got attacked. The findings by Francisco Mojica helped to set up further studies into CRISPR, and this eventually led to the awesome CRISPR-Cas9 gene editing discovery we know today. Even though much of the credits were given to Emmanuel Charpentier and Jennifer Doudna, it was Francisco Mojica who had persisted through for more than a decade in discovering CRISPR and understanding the functions it has. Today, CRISPR-Cas9 is used in multiple industries and has great potentials for drug development, traits improvement in animals and plants for better survival and yield, and efficient ways of producing biofuels. Thank you for watching. That's all for now. Until next time.